Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you what I think is the quickest and most effective way to transform any object into gold. I provided this image of a Statue of Liberty as an example for this tutorial. Its link is in my video's description or project files. First, we'll make a copy of it so we always have the original. Press Ctrl or Command J. We'll separate the statue from the sky by making a selection around the statue. There are many ways to do this, but for this example, open your Quick Selection tool, and at the top, click Select Subject. To check the selection, press Q on your keyboard to see it as a quick mask. You'll notice that there are some areas of the quick mask that are missing, as well as other areas that we need to remove. We'll correct them by first pressing Q again to revert them back into a selection. To fill in areas of the statue, drag the Quick Selection tool over them. To remove areas of the selection that include the sky, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag the tool over them. Now, when we check our selection, we can see it includes our entire statue and none of the sky. Revert it back into a selection. Press Ctrl or Command J to cut and copy the statue onto its own layer. To ensure that our gold statue won't have a subtle fringe around it from the original statue in the layer below it, we'll fill the entire middle layer with the sky. To do this, make the middle layer active and Ctrl or Command click the statue in the top layer to select its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Expand. I'll expand it 20 pixels based on the resolution of this image, which is 150 pixels per inch. If you're using another photo that has a different resolution, expand the selection less or more. Go to Edit and Generative Fill. We could use Content Aware Fill, but for this example, I prefer Generative Fill. Check them both out to see which one you like. Click Generate. Photoshop's AI capabilities give us three variations of sky that fills inside the expanded selection we made. Click on the one you like best. For this example, I'll just keep the first one. We'll merge the Generative Fill layer with the layer under it by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Make the statue active. We'll convert it into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Surface Blur. This filter is especially useful for removing noise and graininess. It essentially blurs an image while preserving its edges. The radius specifies the size of the area sampled for the blur, while the threshold controls how much the pixels must diverge from the center pixel before becoming part of the blur. Let's make the radius 25 pixels and the threshold 10 levels. Next, we'll brighten the shadows of the statue. Go to Image, Adjustments, and Shadows Highlights. Drag the shadows amount all the way to 100%. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Black and White. Presently, our entire image has been desaturated of color. However, we want just the statue to be black and white and not the sky. To restrict the adjustment layer to affect just the statue, we need to make the adjustment layer into a clipping mask. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or go to Layer and create clipping mask. Open the adjustment layer panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Adjustments. Click Curves. If you're using an earlier version of Photoshop, click the icon that looks like this. Clip it to the statue. Curves allows us to adjust contrast by setting and positioning control points along the diagonal line. To create a metallic look to the statue, we'll drag the points up and down, creating three hills and valleys. Feel free to tweak them to adjust the intensity of the brightness and contrast in the shadows, midtones, and highlights. We can always readjust them later at any point if we want. Next, we'll make it a gold color. Open the Adjustment Layer panel again and click Color Balance. Clip it to the statue. For the midtones, make the cyan red 30 and the yellow blue minus 84. Make sure Preserve Luminosity is checked. It maintains the overall tonal balance in our image. Click Shadows. Make the cyan red 21 and the yellow blue minus 52. Click Highlights. Make the cyan red 36 and the yellow blue minus 21. Lastly, we'll slightly darken the brightness of the midtones. Open the Adjustment Layers panel and click Levels. Clip it and make the input midtones 0.85.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.